Inclusive education of the disabled at secondary stage. This is the topic, and now I am going to explain in brief about this particular scheme. The scheme of inclusive education for disabled at secondary stage, or IEDSS, has been launched from the year 2009-10. This scheme replaces the earlier scheme of integrated education for disabled children, that is IEDC, and provides assistance for the inclusive education of the disabled children in classes 9th to 12th. This scheme now subsumed under Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan or RMSA from 2013. Now let's see the aims of this scheme. The first and foremost aim is to enable all students with disabilities to pursue further 4 years of secondary schooling after completing 8 years of elementary schooling in an inclusive and enabling environment. That means enable all students with disabilities completing 8 years of elementary schooling an opportunity to complete 4 years of secondary schooling, that means classes 9th to 12th. The second aim is provide educational opportunities and facilities to students with disabilities in the general education system at the secondary level. And the third aim, support the training of general school teachers to meet the needs of children with disabilities at the secondary level. Now, let's see which are the objectives of this scheme. The first objective is the scheme covers all children studying at the secondary stage in government, local body and government aided schools with one or more disabilities as defined under the Persons with Disabilities Act and the National Trust Act in the class 9th to 12th. Here, the mentioned disabilities include blindness, low vision, leprosy cured, hearing impairment, locomotor disabilities, mental retardation, mental illness, autism and cerebral palsy, and may eventually cover speech impairment, learning disabilities, etc. The second objective is that girls with disabilities receive special focus to help them gain access to secondary schools as also to information and guidance for developing their potential. And lastly, setting up of model inclusive schools in every state is envisaged under this scheme. These are the important objectives of this scheme. Now let's see the components of this particular scheme. There are mainly two components. The first one is student oriented component and other components. The student-oriented components include such as medical and educational assessment, books and stationery, uniforms, transport allowance, reader allowance, stipend for girls, support services, assistive devices, boarding the lodging facility, therapeutic services, teaching learning materials, etc. Now, the other components include appointment of special education teachers, allowances for general teachers for teaching such children, teacher training programs, orientation of school administrators, establishment of resource room, providing barrier-free environment, etc. Now, let's see which is the implementing agency of this particular scheme. The implementing agency is that the school education department of the state governments or union territory. They may involve NGOs having experience in the field of education of the disabled in the implementation of the scheme. And lastly, we have to discuss the financial assistance of this scheme. First one is central assistance for all items covered in the scheme is on 100% basis. And the second one is the state governments are only required to make provisions for scholarship of rupees 600 per disabled children per annum. This is all about inclusive education of the disabled at secondary stage.